Hey, what's up, you guys? Thank you for coming and hanging out with me and checking out this video. If you're new to me, my name is Travis Atreo. I'm a singer, songwriter, producer, and I wanted to start this video series to help you artists along with your musical journey, especially in these times of COVID-19. I've been coaching musicians now for a couple years and helping them develop their skills and help them get their minds right. I wanted to start this series to help all of you out there, especially being quarantined at home. Maybe your gigs are canceled. Maybe things are just looking really bleak. But there are so many ways that we can still continue our careers and we can still make an impact and still make the music that we want to. We just are going to need to dig deep and make it happen. So thank you for being here. Make sure that you hit that subscribe button. Also hit the bell to make sure that you are notified of any new video that I'm posting, any of my covers, any of my original music, but especially these new coaching videos that I'll be putting out every so often. So thank you for being here. So first things first, I've been an artist for a while now. I started in 2006 and in 2014, and it's really been incredible. And I feel really blessed that I have been able to put out music and been able to use platforms like Spotify, like Apple Music, to really help supplement and allow me to become a full-time musician. So today I want to talk about being an artist in 2020. You know, I grew up in the era of bands upon bands, and I was always told by A&R people, by managers, by people in the music industry, these professionals that I looked up to, I was always told to hop in a van and go and tour. And that was the only way that you could ever start a music career. And that's the only way that you could even create and cultivate a fan base. I was in a band called New Heights for a long time. We did that. We found out that debt racks up really easily when you are 20 something year olds borrowing your dad's truck and driving across the US and booking your own shows. I think what we're realizing right now in 2020 and have been realizing for the past decade has been how much the internet has allowed artists like yourselves, like myself, to expand their careers, expand their brands, and really create the careers that we have always wanted. I remember growing up, I always wanted to be like Dashboard Confessionals. Chris Crabbe was my idol, and I wanted to be him all the ways that I could and write music like him. And I always wanted to hit the road and tour. What we're seeing right now is that we may not be able to tour in a traditional way, but we're definitely able to still make an impact. I see things in headlines like how Live Nation, you know, a lot of their markets are disrupted and, you know, they might be going bankrupt and things like that. And, you know, it's a really scary time. So many of my artist friends that depend on touring, that depend on live shows as their income to feed their families and take care of their businesses have completely been wiped out. And it's a really, really tough time for all of us. But one thing that I do want to encourage you guys to do is to start thinking in a different mindset than the traditional ways that we always have seen in the ways that we grew up watching our favorite artists create their careers. It's a different game now. The internet is everything. The internet has broken the system of the traditional music industry and created channels and outlets that allow us to not only connect with our fans, but also be able to create revenue streams for us that are completely untraditional. I went full-time as an artist starting in 2016. I told myself that if I could make enough money from pursuing my music as much as I was making in my day job, then I would start to make the shift and start to put more effort into pursuing that. So in 2016, I made the jump from being a full-time manager of a studio and a producer to pouring all that effort back into my career. The first thing I learned is covers are something that we all can do. And if you enjoy making covers, then do it. There's an amazing thing called SoundDrop. SoundDrop.com, shouting them out right now. I'm not sponsored, but they have been a life changer for me. They not only distribute your music onto any of the platforms that you want them to, like the big players like Spotify, Apple Music, Deezer, Amazon Music, all that stuff, but they also license covers. If you've seen me before, you've seen the many covers that I've done over the years. I've been trying to keep weekly as much as I could over the years, but I have something like 200 something covers that I've posted. And I hear an argument all the time that covers are no longer viable and it's oversaturated. But the thing that people are missing in that statement is they're thinking in relevancy for a macro kind of way. They're looking at well, I can't make an impact anymore. And I want to challenge you to start thinking, not in the macro scheme of things, like let's not try to think that we're going to be the next Taylor Swift or Justin Bieber, but we can have amazing careers if we focus on being a micro influencer, if we focus on being a micro musician. Now, what does that mean? What that means is where you focus on your super fans, you focus on building your audience, you focus on the people that care about your music, and you let all the other noise disappear. I started doing that in about 2015. I started with doing covers. I told myself I wasn't going to release any original music until I had built up at least an audience that I could release music to. What I learned from the New Heights days was that an audience is kind of everything. And I mean that in a business, a music business sort of way. If you cultivate an audience of people and they really love what you do, then you're able to have a community on which you can release music to. One of the things I always tell artists that I'm coaching is focus on creating the music you want, and the audience will come and find you as you continue to create. So the second thing I want to talk about is exactly that. Create the music that you want. There's so many people that tell us of the things that we should create. There's so many cooks in the kitchen at times. And it gets really confusing because I have friends that tell me, oh, you should make music like this. Or I have people telling me, oh, you should make music like this. Even people on my team, you know, tell me that I should make certain music. But if it doesn't come from the outpouring of your heart, if it doesn't come from this gnawing thing in your brain that you want to create, then I would say don't waste your time on it. I've been a producer for a long time and I've produced many different types of genres, and I realized where I want to hone into and what like energy I'm riding at that moment. And I've learned that I create the best when I'm really in love with something. I heard something from producer Tricky Stewart a long time ago. Dave Pensado had asked Tricky Stewart, you know, how is it that you're able to produce so much different type of music? And he said, I don't really see it like that. I just see it as I just follow my heart. I just follow what I love and what I like. So stand firm on the music that you create. Stand firm on the originality that you want to create. And block out all the noise. The third thing I want to talk about today really is blocking out all the noise. You know, with today in music, you know, I hear so many people say it's oversaturated and I won't be able to break through. One thing that I always tell people is that it's not about relevancy anymore. It's about portfolio, and it's about building a mountain of work that your supporters, your fans, and even your potential supporters can devour. Now, what does that mean? What that means is I've had so many times of people that comment on my videos, listen to my music on Spotify, and they tell me they fell into a hole. And they listen for hours, minutes, like they just go on this binge of listening to all of my back catalog. You have to realize that there are people all over the world and they're not gonna be able to hear all of your music. But if you are constantly and consistently creating, regardless if they hear that, when the right people do come along, the right supporters come along, then you're really able to capture them, because you have so much music that they can devour and that they can really marinate on. And every time they hit like, or every time they hit play on another song, they are consuming your music and they're becoming consumed by you and your art. And that is turning them into a super fan. And the super fan is what we want to go after in this day and age. They're the people that will love you regardless, that cherish your work. They see your art as beauty and they are your champions. So we want to go after them. Anyways, that's just really like a little quick tip that I wanted to talk about today, was those three things. It's a new series that I'm trying to create because I've gotten a lot of questions from other people on how they should go about their music business in this day and age. And I want to continue to share different ideas and really help all of you. But I want to inspire you to tell you and show you that it is not too late to be a musician. It is not too late to be an artist. It's not too late to be a creator. Because right now we're all being quarantined, we're being told to stay at home. And because of technology, because of the time that we're in, we have so many different tools at our disposal that can help us create the careers that we've always wanted. So take a chance, my friends, be well, stay safe. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Let me know if you have any tips or tricks that I could totally learn from. I want this to be kind of an open forum. I wanna be of value to you. So let me know, hit me up. And I will see y'all next time. Bye.
just wanna be.